Hello there, Malt Matches. Ralphie here, and welcome to Whisky Review 152. Oh, the excuses I make for myself to have another glass of whisky. As if I needed an excuse. I've been enjoying this one. It's called Smokey Joe, and this is part of a mini-series of other peated whiskies that you may encounter on your malt travels, and you might say, yes, I'll just get another bottle of Ardbeg, but oh my goodness, hasn't the price shot up? Perhaps it's time to try something else. Well, do you know what, malt mates? Yes, it is. This is a fairly recent arrival in the whisky shops, and it is a very good example of a what used to be called a vatted malt. Then the Scotch Whisky Association designated the title as being a blended malt, but I call it a malt blend, because when you say blended, people think blended whisky, a mixture of malt and grain. So confusion all over, but there we go. Perhaps there's a few commentators like myself, indeed there is, who consider it a personal mission to unravel all the confusion, so that when you go into the whisky shops and scan the shelves, or you're online doing your purchasing, which more people are than ever before, and it's a good way of checking out and finding out and buying whisky, it's less of a minefield. Non-chill filtered, 46%. My goodness, this is looking up. Well, of course you can tell that I've been thoroughly enjoying it, actually. And it's produced by the, what company? The leading Scotch whisky company, which is another title for one of the prominent independent bottlers out there. Smokey Joe, as the name suggests, is an Islay-dominated whisky. It's been fascinating. I've shared this, actually, this bottle with some fellow malt mates in Glasgow's Whisky Club, and has been thoroughly enjoyed. Because it is good quality stuff. Having applied my nose and taste buds to this repeatedly over the last month, I can confirm it's not a single malt, otherwise it would state that it was a single malt. It's a blend of malts, a malt blend. And I can sum it up by saying it's a sort of 12 to 14 year old, really quite rounded, slightly floral, citrus, peaty combination of Kulila, Beaumore and Laphroaig, providing that more iodine of notes, all bound together in some dry brown sugar. That's it summarised. Now I'll go over the nose first of all. Incidentally, because it's fairly new out and it hasn't got an established market for this particular brand, the prices are quite good. Certainly in the UK it has been slightly discounted in some of the shops, which makes it more appealing as a purchase for those of us on a budget. And of course it's below the radar, it's not a main brand, and therefore it tends to get overlooked, and because of that it has to try harder to succeed, and it does. A lovely fennel licorice brown sugar, certainly at the beginning of the bottle it was a lot more Kulila, had that bonfireiness to it. As the bottle's gone down, the oxidisation inside has kind of levelled out the whiskies involved, and you notice more of the Bowmore actually. It was the Lafroig was kind of off the map slightly on first experience with this. Then it became prominent, and now it seems to be the Bowmore. If there's any Bowmore in it, it's just an opinion. And these guys, quite rightly, tend to keep the recipes to themselves when they're producing the amber nectar. There's some young whiskey in there, but there's an older whiskey kind of rounding it off. I suspect the Cooleela's older and the Bowmore's younger. It's got a lovely, slightly firework arrival, but there's a real intense, rich, boiled fruitiness to it, like a fruitcake. There is a heat, but the heat's restrained by the older whiskies rounding things off. Now, I have to say that this is a perfect opportunity as I sort out my marks for this one. It's the case that single malts get all the attention. Single malts are considered to be the best, all full of flavour and all the rest of it. And some of them can be quite expensive, particularly if they've been designer packaged. They become extravagantly so, and it's interesting to note that there are some releases at this moment in time in October 2010 of some hugely ornate bottles of very old whisky from the likes of Macallan, Highland Park and Bowmore. And they're designed for Russian businessmen, Chinese businessmen and very wealthy pop stars and all the rest of it. And it really is a top class exercise in style over substance, because I firmly believe that if a whisky has not reached its destination after 30 years, then it is a very slow cask indeed. And perhaps there's a reason for that. Nothing against old expensive whisky. If that floats your boat, fine. But having tasted a few old whiskies, sometimes if you've got experience, they really don't justify the price. They really don't. And if you can get a hold with the knowledge, get a hold of something like this, Smokey Joe, relatively young whisky, mixture of single malts, tends to be kind of regarded as a bit less of a whisky event, but not a bit of it. It's amazing how single malts can work successfully together to become more than the sum of their parts, and that's happening here. And I certainly recommend this. I'm going to give this 88 out of 100. And bear in mind, it's 46%, it's non-chill filtered, and by the looks of it, I don't think there's any caramel in there either, although it would be rather handy if they'd state it on the label. And then there wouldn't be any doubts in our minds. Lovely, lovely stuff. If you go to the Whiskey Exchange, Binnie's, if you go into a specialist whiskey retailer and just ask them, what do you have in the way of blended malts, malt blends, vatted malts, and just see what they've got on their shelves and get their advice, because the guys, particularly in the specialist shop, they tend to take pride in what they're doing, generally speaking, and they can be very helpful indeed. So there you have it. Lovely whiskey. I haven't even added water to this, funnily enough. It's really nice on its own. Rafi.com. I think I'll pour myself another glass and have a cup of coffee with it and a piece of chocolate. Lovely. See you soon.